Hey folks, this is Vince with Dad's Gaming Addiction, and today we're going to take another quick look at the Star Wars X-Wing miniatures game. Now today we're going to look at the Z95 Headhunter expansion. It just came in the mail today, so I really haven't had a chance to look at it. Though, if I had to describe them, they are considered, well, at least I consider them, to be the red shirts of the Rebel Alliance. Fairly cheap to produce, and are probably the most vulnerable out of all of the ships. Just in glancing at the cards, I really haven't had a chance to look at them, but just in glancing, I saw a shield strength of 2 and a hull value of 2. When you compare that to the Y-Wing that has 8 points all around, I think it's like 5 hull and 3 shields, or 3 shields, 5 hull, something like that. I don't have them memorized, but if you know, when you compare the values like that, the Y-Wing has 4 more hit points, I want to say, more than the Z95 Headhunter does. And that makes a big difference when you're out on the battlefield. Now, to make up for that, the Z95s have a pretty low point cost, so it's sort of comparable to, say, the TIE Fighters. So, with that said, let's take a brief look at what this particular expansion has to offer. Okay, here's a brief snapshot of the components minus all of the little tokens. Again, these expansions usually come with a lot of different tokens. You've got target locks, for example, and shields, and focus tokens. Just keep in the back of your mind that the tokens that come with expansions like this usually reflect the ship class in question. So here's a brief look then at the model. Let's go ahead and focus in on that. As you can see, it's very similar to an X-Wing, except that it only has 2 wings and not 4. The S-foils don't split apart like the X-Wings do. Alright, as far as the maneuvers go, it can make a slight left or slight right at 1, that's a white maneuver, or it can go straight at 1, that's a green maneuver. On to the 2s, it can make a hard left or a hard right at 2, it's a white maneuver. Slight left, slight right, or going straight at 2 are green maneuvers. On to the 3s, all of the maneuvers here are white. Hard left, straight, slight right, hard right. Those are all white maneuvers. It can also make a K-turn at 3. It's a red maneuver. And finally, it can go 4 straight, which is a white maneuver. No K-turn at 4 or 5. Alright, as far as your pilots are concerned, we'll start with Aaron Kraken, pilot skill of 8, 2s across the board as far as stats go. 2 attack, 2 agility, 2 hull, 2 shields. Special ability. After you perform an attack, you may choose another friendly ship at range 1. That ship may perform 1 free action. Focus, target lock actions, you've got some upgrades down here, point cost of 19. Further in, we have Lieutenant Blount, hopefully I pronounced that right. Pilot skill of 6, again, 2s all across the board. When attacking, the defender is hit by your attack even if he does not suffer any damage. That comes into play with, I believe it's the Ion Pulse missile, if memory serves. We'll get to that in a minute. Focus, target lock, and an upgrade or point cost of 17. Next up, you have this Talos Squadron pilot. Pilot skill 4, no special ability, focus, target lock, upgrade, point cost of 13. Finally, you've got the Bandit Squadron pilot. Pilot skill of 2, no special ability, focus, target lock, one upgrade down here, and you've got a point cost of 12. Alright, upgrade cards. Assault missiles, we've seen these before. 4 attack dice, range 2 to 3, cost of 5. Attack, target lock. Spend your target lock and discard this card to perform this attack. If this attack hits, each other ship at range 1 of the defender suffers 1 damage. So great for taking out those pesky swarms. Ion Pulse missiles, this is the card I was referring to earlier. 3 attack dice, range 2 to 3, cost of 3. Attack, target lock. You have to discard this card to perform this attack. If this attack hits, the defender suffers 1 damage and receives 2 ion tokens, then cancel all dice results. So it's similar to the ion token itself, only it's a missile. Wingman. This is a new card. At the start of the combat phase, remove 1 stress token from another friendly ship at range 1. Pretty awesome. That has a cost of 2. Decoy. At the start of the combat phase, you may choose 1 friendly ship at range 1 to 2. Exchange your pilot skill with that ship's pilot skill until the end of the phase. Cost of 2. Munitions Failsafe. Another great card from what I'm looking at. It has a cost of 1. When attacking with a secondary weapon that instructs you to discard it, to perform the attack, do not discard it unless the attack hits. So if you shoot a concussion missile or proton torpedo, whatever, and it doesn't hit, and you have this card, you don't have to discard it. So that's a really cool upgrade. And for 1 point, I think that's really valuable. And there you have it, a quick look at the Z95 Headhunter expansion. I do have some of the other Wave 4 ships sitting on my desk. I think I have the E-Wing and the TIE Phantom sitting over there. Still waiting on the TIE Defender. This is a Wave 4 ship as well. Again, there are typically 4 ships per wave, and I want to say about 4 waves currently out on the market. And then you've also got your Epic ships and the Imperial Aces. And I think the Rebel Aces will be coming soon. So, with that said, stay tuned for some more videos regarding those respective ships. You can also check out my website, www.dadsgamingaddiction.com. This is Vince, thanks for watching, and I'll catch you next time.